as well, so he can sneak up top, but
not quite, Joey.
Not quite.
That's what it's going to take for this race. We're going to see that all day long. Pushes on starts, restarts. You want to get out front as quick as you can and set the pace.
Gregson jumps to the high lane. Behind him now, teammate Josh Berry.
That's what you want in a situation like this. Put my teammate behind me. That's the safest player you can have behind you drafting with you. This is one of those racetracks you're not going to be able to really do it on your own. It's going to be nice to have a little bit of help.
Top lane's already showing some strength. We saw that in the truck race here just an hour or two before here, Joey, where that top lane really builds momentum on the corner exits and carries that speed. Bottom lane, not so much on the straightaways, but in the corners, that shorter distance gains some time and speed.
Does that surprise you that the high lane has been the way to go? I think so many people anticipated you'd want to be on that bottom line.
Well, it doesn't look like it's... I mean, the top's definitely got more cars up there for sure, but, you know, eventually if you got to start lifting because you're behind cars so much, that bottom lane could start to prevail again, as we see right now.
Great start for the series here. You know, this was a track we were worried about the start. We worried we'd see a lot of attrition, and we still might. We're very early in the race. I might have already
jinxed
it.
Did you say that? Three wide?
But great start. So far, it had been really calm up until I opened my mouth here, guys.
Well, that's what we're talking about. This isn't Daytona anymore, where the cars are just bolted to the racetrack and got a ton of grip. You've seen AJ just get loose and slide up the racetrack a little bit. That's where this track is kind of in between those two.
The 11 up the middle, Daniel Hemric, nearly won this race.